So why were these killer whales chasing the boat that day? And what were they after? Killer whales, or orca, are some of the ocean's largest and most powerful predators. They're intelligent, organized, and ruthless. They're a true force to be reckoned with. The two types of killer whale that we best know are resident and transient killer whales. Now, the resident groups tend to stay around coastlines and predominantly feed on fish, whereas the transient killer whales are fearsome hunters, roaming the oceans looking for seals, sea lions, and even whales to prey upon. So if we know they're capable of that,
right here.
Perhaps the killer whale saw Richard and Laura as lunch. Even being on a boat doesn't necessarily mean you're safe. When Weddell seals are found resting out of the water in Antarctica, it's no problem for the orca. The pod swim towards the iceberg in unison to create a wave that topples the seal into the water. And I'm afraid there's only one winner. So have these Mexican killers learned a similar trick? Well, perhaps the answer lies with some of their relatives. Despite the name, killer whales are in fact the largest member of the dolphin family. And smaller dolphins are known for surfing waves and riding the bows of boats. So, is there a link? The one man who can help shed some light on this mystery is zoologist Mark Cowardine.
It's amazing how many times I've been on a boat travelling in one direction and you're passing a school of dolphins and they will turn around 180 degrees to come up to the boat and play with it. And they've obviously realised over the years that that boats just mean fun.
There is still one crucial difference, though. The dolphins are being pushed along at the front of the boat. But on this day in Mexico, the killers were at the back, in the boat's wake. So can this really be the same thing?
Well, there's no doubt the whales will have gone to the boat because they just want to have a good time.
But this type of play behaviour isn't exclusively for fun. Swimming close together, they're actually learning to hunt.
It's quite a useful technique to develop and learn because it's useful in hunting. You know, they'll be working as a team when they're hunting and they'll instinctively know when to take over, when to move position.
This orchestrated training session gives the killer whales an advantage when it comes to a real hunt, building stamina and developing teamwork in this man-made surf school.